Ah, it's good to be back.
When we last left off, I performed raw, hardcore, mostly uncensored analysis of all of Armored Skeptic's data supporting his view of gender expression, which didn't take too long because he didn't have any. This time, we're going to do some more of that about some more people. Nothing particularly unique this time, I just thought it'd be nice to cover a few more people. I wanted to do more last time, but the video started to feel like it was dragging, you know? Let's have another look and see if there are any decent rebuttals to Nye's recent work. We'll be looking for a couple of basic things, like if the arguments actually hold water when you look at them, if they have any sources or data that they cite, if they put it in the description so people can click to check if it's actually right or not. You know, really basic stuff like that. I'm sure that's a low bar that no one will be tripped over, right?
Who's first?
Well, there's this mouthy Buddha guy. His attempts to criticize Rachel Bloom's musical segment caused him to devolve into screaming "my pussy" over and over until he was literally just reverberating and pulling a stupid face.
My pussy! My pussy! My pussy talks! My pussy! My pussy!
He seems like a lovely individual. He's using the very popular rhetorical strategy of acting like a fucking idiot and then saying, "That's what I think feminism is! Me being stupid proves they're stupid!" I put some jokes at his expense in the last video, and I thought it would be funny to just use that clip of him doing that and then not go back to him ever again, but even if I wanted to do more than that, I'd have some trouble, because the video is mostly just him whining about how morally evil it is that Rachel Bloom empowered ignorant women, and how betrayed he feels by Bill Nye for not saying what he decided was true about the issue.
Dude, name the smartest people in the world. They all think this gender fluidity shit is bullshit.
No evidence is necessary to support his beliefs, apparently.
Who is this empowering? It's empowering ignorant women. People that you are dancing with are making our civilized Western culture more and more degenerate every day.
I thought feminists were worthless and unproductive members of society, but according to genius non-foot shooter Mouthy Buddha, it turns out that actually Western civilization is so weak and vulnerable that Rachel Bloom can destroy it with a song about her vagina.
Listen, mate, if you think our great civilization is that weak, maybe you should move somewhere else, presumably back to the spitting image puppet dimension.
His other videos try really hard to be dramatic pseudo-documentaries with text effects, ornate fonts, and important-sounding music as he talks in a dramatic voice about how IQ is totally a real measurement of human ability and behavior.
We need to understand the validity of IQ, to know that this is real and predictive of human behavior.
You know, for someone who seems incredibly certain that IQ is a valid and important unit of measuring a person's intelligence, Mouthy Buddha doesn't appear to have listed his own IQ anywhere. I invite you to come to the one conclusion there can be about why he wouldn't do that. These videos attempt to create the illusion that he's smart and needs to be taken seriously, but he's already put out a video where he whines and vibrates at a camera, so the genie's out of the bottle there, mate. While I could point and laugh at how he's a libertarian trying desperately to backpedal from supporting the alt-right after realizing that his bedfellows don't seem to realize that eugenics is unethical, or pretend that his other work means he's worth taking seriously, I think it would be funnier not to. Who's next?
Do you have any idea how reputationally damning this is?
Well, there's this guy who calls himself Some Black Guy. His video's entitled "Bill Nye Ruins My Childhood." Oh dear, did the science man hurt your feelings? But I thought rational people put facts over feelings.
Bill Nye is now diving into the magical fantasy land of progressive identity politics, and he's doing it by his show, Bill Nye Saves the World, and I've only seen bits and pieces of it, and I'm not gonna watch it all the way through.
Oh great, not only has he not actually seen the show, just the cherry-picked chunks that ended up on YouTube, he doesn't even plan on watching it. Points for honesty, I guess. For most of the video, he plays clips from the scant bits he has seen and pauses them to cut away and try and make a clever riff. Standard cutaway commentary stuff.
But it's actually a lot sexier than that.
I don't know about you guys, but there's absolutely nothing sexy about this whatsoever.
Heh. Bill said it was sexy for a joke, and the audience laughed along because it was a joke. But Derek says it isn't very sexy at all. Oh my god, he's got him. He's owning him online. With discourse. Can you feel the logic and reason yet? And then for the rest of the video, he extemporizes about the horrifying state of the world now that some people identify as non-binary.
And now you have a bunch of people that just want to be heard. They don't want to be normal. They want to live in this fantasy world where there's all these different options and shit.
Oh no! People want to have options now.
Like, you're starting to see on websites where they have multiple options for gender, where it was just always man or woman. Now there's like, oh, fuck that. No, non-binary or something else should be an option. I'm like, why? It's not that fucking serious, dude. I mean, I know to a lot of people it is, but in the grand scale of things, this is extremely trivial.
I agree, it is extremely trivial. When someone comes up to me and says, I'd rather you refer to me by these pronouns from now on, I say, yeah, all right, because it's really not that hard, and it doesn't really affect my life all that much. Oh no, sorry, you meant the other kind of trivial, the kind where you spend days of your life recording YouTube videos complaining about it while insisting that it's trivial. Sure.
An astral will help with that, and who better to talk about sex than two cis male white guys?
This dude is falling off the deep end. Why couldn't these people, why couldn't Bill Nye or anybody, any cis white man, or just a cis male for talk about this type of stuff? Like, why is this even mentioned? Why would you say that? How is that even funny?
My favorite part of this clip is that he realizes at the very end, asking these dumbass questions about why would you dare say that Bill was just making a joke. So he suddenly cuts himself off and goes, how is that even funny? Like, you can see the moment he realizes that maybe Bill Nye's sentence shouldn't be taken literally seriously, but he can't admit he fucked up, so he just cuts himself off and goes, well, it wasn't funny either. Nye wasn't saying that cis male white guys aren't allowed to talk about sex, because they are. They continue to do so after making the joke. I'm really surprised by how easily these folks are tripped by jokes. Now, I could just systematically own Derek for all the stupid shit he says over the course of the video, but I've set myself the lofty goal of cutting through the chaff and analyzing the core claims themselves that appear to be holding up the rest of the rants, and seeing if at least they hold water. You know, all of this bullshit is bullshit, but he might have a point in there somewhere, so I did some digging and found Derek's central claim, which is that Bill Nye has gone against the science, and he knows this is what's happened because real scientists used to say otherwise.
But now he wants to play make-believe and say stuff like, oh, gender is on a spectrum, like sex, you know, there's such a thing as like non-binary and stuff like that, when, you know, before, and like any other science or scientist that has come before him has just said there's two genders and they're determined by the chromosomes.
Chromosomes? Whatever, he probably misspoke. He doesn't provide any data or studies to support the idea that gender is determined by chromosomes, but he also doesn't even dare say that himself. Instead he says, well, scientists say it, and he believes those scientists over Bill because, well, they say what he thinks is true. Certainly not because he's seen the evidence himself, because then he'd have bothered to show it to the viewer and not hide behind scientists say it, wouldn't he? The funny thing is, he tries and fails to claim that this is what Bill used to say. This next clip is unintentionally amazing.
Something that he said himself as well.
In an act of utter hilarity, after saying this used to be what Bill said himself, he cuts to a scene from an old episode of Science Guy where someone who is definitely not Bill himself explains chromosomes.
Before you're born, your mom gives you one of her chromosomes and your dad gives you one of his.
Now, we're going to investigate that claim in a little more detail in a sec, but first, let's stop and think like video editors for a bit. Look, it's my one actual area of expertise. I was going to shoehorn this bit in somewhere.
I'm going to be charitable here and assume that Derek did some research in advance. He probably at least watched some of the clips from the ice cream bit or the musical bit that people were spreading on YouTube, and saw people claiming on Twitter that Nye used to say gender's caused by chromosomes, and then hit record assuming Bill had actually said it. Now, the question is,
why would he think Bill had actually said it himself in the first place? He must have got this idea from somewhere. Well, in the spheres Derek runs in, a very popular image was circulating on Twitter with a picture of Bill holding up a diagram of chromosomes with subtitles claiming they decide a person's gender. These subtitles were fake. Nye said nothing of the sort in that actual segment. The image was spread by noted bastion of truth and ant enthusiast Ian Miles Chong in the hopes of convincing gullible idiots. And, well, evidently it did. It appears that Derek here took it for granted that that was what Bill had said, and didn't even check it was true until after recording. So we had to use this clip of someone else saying something that you could twist to be about gender instead.
Now, I'm just spitballing here. There's no way of proving that's the exact chain of events. Derek could have just missed the widely shared lie, tweeted by Chong, who he follows on Twitter, and which was originally tweeted just minutes before Derek tweeted, "Why is Bill Nye all over my feed?" You know, it could have been a different chain of events, but it wasn't. Now, I'm not saying Derek saw a fake screenshot and took it as fact without checking, and that this is antithetical to the very principles he claims Bill Nye has abandoned, but it certainly looks exactly like that.
However, let's ignore this blatant ignorance and hypocrisy and talk a little about the segment he did end up using, featuring someone who isn't Bill Nye talking about chromosomes. This clip is also widely used elsewhere to claim Nye's previous show was right, and then he got infected by feminism or something. Derek contrasts this old clip from 1996 with his present stance on the issue in his new show.
Many months later.
I used to think there were just two settings, male and female.
At least you actually had a clip of Bill talking about the issue this time, Derek. The implication, of course, is that Nye has abandoned the science and become a liar, but this reflects a very poor understanding of the absolute basics of Bill Nye's old show and how it was constructed primarily to give children a baseline understanding of science in the 90s. The old show, I hate to point out, never really did cover sex, gender, or sexuality in much detail, if at all. Covering these issues on a show for kids in the 90s was pretty much off limits. You'd come under fire for indoctrinating children into an evil agenda and other gay panic nonsense bullshit garbage. You know, the sort of thing similar neo-Puritans would do in the modern day if, let's say, there was a YouTube channel aimed at educating kids about these issues. I wonder why the producers wanted to avoid the ire of Derek's ideological predecessors and risk getting pulled from the air or sent death threats. They steered well clear and, to my knowledge, only ever barely broach the subject of sex differences when it's in relation to something else. The segment all the idiots are pointing to is from an episode about probability. No, not sex, not here's an episode on how chromosomes work, probability. Imagine for a moment that you're one of the writers of this show. Let's say you're writing an episode of a science show about probability, and you have 23 minutes to explain it to an audience, and an example you want to give is the probability of which sex you were born.
And if Dad gives you an X2, then you become a girl. But if he gives you his Y, then you become a boy.
Even though, because you know your stuff, because you're a researcher for a show about science, the science behind transgender people is known to you, you're writing in an era where, generally speaking, the terms sex and gender are conflated in common parlance. And you're writing a show for kids. In fact, you're writing lines for an actual kid to say, so you have her say, if you have a Y chromosome, you're a boy, for convenience's sake. You also wrote a funny skit where Bill picks the wrong door to his lab and falls off the roof of a building.
See, there are only two possibilities.
You know, as a writer for the show, that there's a probability of a person being intersex or other rare chromosomal differences that complicate this simple 1 in 2 probability, but you know that taking the time to explain this here would mean cutting into the Wizard of Oz skit where you reenact the Wizard of Oz but with Bill Nye as the wizard.
If you want to improve the chances of getting home safely, wear a seatbelt.
The chance of becoming either a boy or a girl is always 1 in 2. A 50-50 chance either way. It's like flipping a coin.
Mm-hmm.
X, you're a girl, Y, you're a boy.
You also, because you're not an idiot, have done more than 5 seconds of research and know that the probability in most industrialized nations of being born physically male is generally higher than being born physically female. So the chances are more like 1.05 in 2, meaning it's not like flipping a coin so much as like flipping a coin that's very slightly weighted as a result of complex environmental factors. And there's also the rare but real possibility of the coin landing on its side. You don't bring this up either, because Bill really doesn't want to cut the skit where he counts dice possibilities next to
the giant fan he stole from the set of Blade Runner, and since the video is boiling down probabilities for children, you leave it out, hoping people more discerning of the science will understand why you left it out, and privately you pray that none of the kids in the audience will grow up to call Bill Nye a liar when he explains the more complicated version to them as adults. Does he cite any sources to back up his claims throughout the video? Why, some black guy gives an exhaustingly comprehensive list of his merch store, Patreon, PayPal, Second Channel, Twitch, Instagram, AskFM, Snapchat, Email, Grindr, Chimney, Splango, etc., etc. Unfortunately, he doesn't cite any sources because he doesn't have any to back up his beliefs, but he feels very strongly that he's right, and that's why you should check out the t-shirts for sale in his merch store, for example this one about how facts are more important than feelings. And he's right. In making an informed argument, facts are important. Would have been great if he'd had any, wouldn't it? Some black guy, more like some lack of evidence guy. Oh, cut that out. That's just rubbish. I hope you're sick of bullshit, because here's YouTuber No Bullshit with his video entitled Bill Nye Goes Full SJW, Trashes Whites, Praises Transgenders and Gays, and by No Bullshit, I apparently meant to say no sources. I bet we're in for a real science and research fest here.
I'm sick of people overinflating the amounts of gay and transgender people in the population. And I have nothing against the people, don't get me wrong. I'm just sick of this overly gay, overly pro-trans narrative being pushed everywhere. Everywhere that toes the line with the liberal SJW PC crowd. It's gotten beyond annoying and is verging into unsettling and disturbing places.
When I clicked a video by someone called No Bullshit, I thought I was entering an intellectual thunderdome. But so far all he's done is complain about the overly gay, overly pro-trans narrative that's being pushed everywhere by the liberals. I thought this was supposed to be about science, but this guy's just sharing his feelings about the liberals. What is this? No Bullshit's whole deal appears to be to pause during whatever he's watching partway through to fantasize about the deep, hidden emotions or the evil agendas of the people on screen.
God, even the new theme song is shittier, and it just screams, I'm desperate to be cool and hip again. Here's a black guy singing my theme song. I'm down.
Now either Mr. Bullshit, if that is his real name, which I'm going to assume it is, can read minds, or he's just written an elaborate fanfiction about Bill Nye wanting to look hip, so he personally gets Tyler the Creator to make the new theme. Because apparently no one else is involved with the production of a show. You know, the man the cameras are pointed at, he personally writes it all, he commissions everything that goes into the show, he personally hires all the animators. You know, it's all Bill Nye. It's not like there's a production crew or anything.
And who better to talk about sex than two cis male white guys?
And this is also where I lose all hope for this show. Anyone who uses the word cis is either an SJW whack job, or there's someone who is trying to pander to them.
If you hear someone say a word you don't like, pause the video to complain about how that makes them the bad people. Bonus points if you then go on to make videos complaining about how everyone else is easily offended by words.
They pull it off with so much confidence that it doesn't feel weird, it just feels like, hey.
So now we jump to Veritasium on location in Korea. And to be honest, listening to this K-pop weirdo talk, I feel the same way Veritasium looks. He looks squinty, he's looking down on this creeper, raising his upper lip in disgust.
He looks squinty, and that means he's looking down on the person he's interviewing. He secretly hates them.
This Rachel Bloom bitch sounds like she's trying to be the next Amy Schumer or something. My vagina, my vagina. No one cares about your gross vagina, lady.
I'm not gonna even touch those, frankly, Freudian comments about finding vaginas weird. Now, as can be plainly seen, this No Bullshit fellow doesn't really have any understanding of the science, and isn't all that bright otherwise. So, he doesn't even really understand why he's so angry that the show is too pro-gay. So he wallpapers over the cracks in his own understanding by imagining that everyone on screen is sad and angry and hateful and wants to look cool and is pushing an agenda and is an evil liberal and wants to be like Amy Schumer. Which doesn't really make any sense. No one wants to be like Amy Schumer. Not even Amy Schumer wants to be like Amy Schumer.
Now, if I really wanted to, I could go through the entire video and make one of my patented citation-needed jokes every single time he makes a claim and then doesn't support it with any evidence whatsoever.
This still doesn't change the fact that there are only two genders.
But instead, I decided to take a leaf out of his book and just imagine that he likes the smell of his own farts and then move on without thinking about him too much. Ugh, we're running out of people pretending they have compelling arguments. Quick, what about previous appearance have a red pill philosophy? The guy who couldn't even remember the names of the main characters of The Force Awakens in the car after getting out of the theater. Maybe his video, Bill Nye's Netflix show trashes white people, glorifies transgender. Wait, haven't we seen that title before?
So it's like a game. You guys are writing the same thing.
I love that clip. It's from Roosh complaining to some journalists, accusing them of secretly plotting to push a unified narrative by writing similar articles, as if there's a multitude of ways of reporting about his legalized rape article. But I like reusing it in a better context of people in his sphere copying each other's work. I can't wait for them to start suing each other. Those court cases are going to be hilarious. But speaking of doing the same thing, at this point I'm starting to see a lot of repeat performances trotting out the same arguments again and again in new, even more uninformed incarnations. We've got the lecturing the white race argument.
Some Indian dude came on to Bill Nye's show to lecture white people about cultural appropriation.
Prashant's lectured the entire white race on how it's unacceptable to use Asian mysticism because it's from a different culture.
You've got complaints that it's too political to even talk about this stuff, or even outright fantasies of a secret liberal agenda.
Pushing leftist liberal SJW narratives.
This episode is very clearly politically driven.
Oh, it's politics, like bringing the politics into the science.
And we've got the same sob stories about how he used to like Bill, but then he betrayed me.
Bill Nye is a childhood hero to a lot of people, including myself.
His television show, Bill Nye the Science Guy, was informative, innovative, and entertaining. I was extremely excited when Netflix announced that they'd be releasing a brand new Bill Nye series.
You used to be a voice for hard science. When I was a child, you were just this cool figure for science. You are a representative of science, and you just shit over all of it.
And of course, we've got the fantastic repeat performance of not bothering to cite any sources or studies to back up any of their claims. At this point, my mind's a blur. I can't honestly tell you what Red Pill Philosophy said in his video, and the first time I watched it, I wasn't sure if I'd somehow seen it before and forgotten. I've tried to rewatch it and see if he says anything worth specifically debunking, but my eyes just slide off him and I start to think about all the vacuuming I could be doing.
Bill Nye, the establishment guy, is nothing but an establishment shill, nothing but establishment propaganda. If you go to the Twitter page of that March for Science Twitter page, that establishment propaganda, Bill Nye the propaganda guy, Bill Nye the establishment guy. So Bill Nye the propaganda guy, Bill Nye the establishment shill guy.
At this point in my quest, I was desperate for someone, anyone, who had something different to say. It didn't even have to be right. At this point, a different set of wrong arguments would have been enough to make me feel alive again. And then, out of the darkness, came Rage After Storm. Rage After Storm is one of those YouTubers who actively courts a far-right audience and likes to talk about how race is real and tweet about how Hitler had some really good ideas. This video is entitled Bill Nye the Jewish Guy.
Please stop getting triggered over the Jew thing. It's a reference to the nose. It was just banter.
The video opens a little familiarly to begin with the standard totally not fabricated Bill Nye sob story. I loved him and it made me want to think about stuff, but then he said the bad thing.
Look, I know that so many people are starting to catch this SJW virus, but I never knew that it would be my dearest Bill. I respected him so much. No, really, he was my muse.
But then she goes off the fucking chain! She one-ups Armored Skeptic's ice cream slut-shaming and begins trying to figure out which sexualities the ice creams represent in the comedy ice cream cartoon.
You have vanilla that's straight. One of the flavors then has to be a lesbian. One of them has to be gay. One of them has to be bisexual. Okay, someone over here is a fucked up ice cream.
She's trying to fucking diagnose cartoon ice creams. Which sexuality are you? Let me get out my ice cream speculum.
Chocolate chip.
Sorry I'm late.
I was busy being two awesome things at once.
Okay, nope, Choco Chip is obviously bisexual. This is weird.
Actually, chocolate chip is pretty straightforwardly a metaphor for non-binary or intersex people. You know, being two awesome things at once. Not enjoys licking two different kinds of ice cream at once. She can't even pass the most basic point of the segment.
Get in her nuts.
Can we not encourage gangbangs, please? Can we teach people a bit of decency? Having a gangbang is not something to be proud of.
Well, someone isn't invited to my next house party, I can tell you. Not because of that, though, because of the Hitler apologetics.
Again, this is exactly how STDs spread. Being slutty is not cool.
No, being uneducated about STDs and how they spread is how they spread.
Imagine that. The real problem being people being uneducated on the issue. Imagine if that was the real problem here.
So she continues to moral panic about how the show is promoting being bi as cool too much and how it's tricking people into wanting to be bi to be trendy. You know, because that's how sexuality works.
Just in general, why are we advertising the fact that bisexuality is cool?
This isn't a particularly uncommon approach to sexuality either. You see it everywhere in conservative criticism of progressive media. Like with No Bullshit, the problem isn't that LGBT people exist. Of course not. They love gay people. The problem is the overly pro-LGBT narrative. From their perspective, the issue is people being too nice about the bees, the gyars, the lesbs, and the transes, and that throws off the delicate balance of nature or something. You know, they think these people are allowed to exist, and that's fine, that's okay, we've finally gotten them that far. But they have to exist in the background somewhere. You can't accidentally make it look like it's okay to be like that, because that's basically just pushing their agenda on people.
None of it is meant to be like a fashion craze or a trend or something that's cool, okay? It's not. This provides people with pressure.
Pressuring people into becoming bi and having orgies? Is that really what the cartoon ice cream skit does to people? This might just be my opinion, but I don't think many people are going to have their sexuality changed or their identity radically altered by media presenting it as okay to not be straight or not be, I'm going to say the bad word, cover your ears, cisgendered. I'm at the risk of sounding a little bit stubborn here, but I just don't accept that people who are secure in their own sexuality are going to have theirs changed by other people being open about their own. Which is why my conscience will be clear when, at the end of this sentence, I cut to a graphic depiction of what I get up to in my bed every single night.
No, I'm playing Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. You can play it anywhere, because it's portable. It's a really good game, guys.
But don't get me wrong, that doesn't mean that there aren't very positive effects of having good representations of LGBT people in media. This kind of goes without saying, but generally speaking, it's healthy for a person to feel like they're allowed to express themselves and their identity without fear of not being accepted or of being treated like they're lesser as a result of it. Perceiving positive representations of LGBT people as some kind of insidious trick is, academically speaking, very stupid.
Versatile love may have some butt stuff.
Ew.
I think that short clip of someone saying butt stuff and cutting to her saying ew sums up her coverage of most of this episode. She seems to be aware of how little she has to say, though, so she quickly moves on to the episode dealing with overpopulation and carbon footprint and what to do about it. Someone on the panel talks about the much lower carbon footprint of people in a non-Western country, and we get this, well, just watch.
How many does the average American emit?
I did that with my coffee this morning.
Yeah. Exactly. 16 metric tons. Wow. Is
so
what the
160
average
times.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. And so our two kids are way more problematic. The Nigerians with an average 7 children are not the problem when it comes to climate change.
The reason why they have so many fucking kids is not because they care about what's happening with the environment. I'm pretty sure Botswana over in Africa is not popping out kids and thinking, it's okay, I can have this 7th kid, it's sustainable, it's okay, I'm not using all this CO2, I'm not creating greenhouse gases. No, they have kids to fuel selfish ways of getting them to look after them when they're older. They have kids because they know that child that they're popping out right now will probably die from famine, diseases, or both. Contraception for them is out of the window anyway. I mean, they don't even know how to put on a fucking condom. I mean, can we really trust these people to take a contraceptive pill every day? Can we really? The answer is no.
This video took a fucking turn. She takes the comment about the lower carbon footprint of people in Western Africa and just goes off on a rant about how stupid and bad those people are, how they can't be trusted to put on a condom. She doesn't even appear to notice that the image she's using to stereotype an entire continent of people is literally taken from the website nationalstereotype.com.
So should we have policies that penalize people for having extra kids in the developed world?
So I do think that we should at least consider it.
Oh yeah, that's a great idea. So let's get people in Western countries to stop-
I'll let this unhinged rant continue, but let's just pause for a second and keep in mind that what the guy actually said was, I think we should at least consider it. Remember that she's this angry about a very non-committal comment about how we should maybe at least think about it. Remember that she's angry here about the idea of thinking about something.
Let's get people in Western countries to stop having kids, you know, the people that are actually solving the problems with climate change, so then people in the third world can overpopulate us.
That's right, Rage After Storm's talking about the Great Replacement, the easily debunkable idea that foreigners are going to take over the West by outbreeding us because of differences in birth rates.
They were importing these third worlders into Western countries like Germany, where the population is aging and on a decline.
They're importing foreigners and they're going to take over. She even uses the phrase replacement rate. If you'd like to know more about this idea and why it's total bullshit, actual skepticism user and skull reclaimer Sean Andjan did a video debunking it handily. So handily that it got false flagged and taken down for a while by idiots because its existence was inconvenient for them. Check it out. Rage's version of the Great Replacement is even less informed and even more overtly racist than it normally is.
And by saying to the residents of the third world, oh yeah, no, you keep on having kids, you are basically shooting yourself in the foot. When I'm out and about and I see people with loads of kids, it's either people that look like they dance around wind turbines with hemp sandals on, or people who aren't really Western Europeans.
She concludes that the solution is education.
And I guarantee you, the way to solve this issue is by education.
I agree. Some people could certainly do with knowing a bit more about the issues before they open their mouth to dog whistle about being replaced by immigrants. Mwah, mwah. Now, some people who are watching this video might genuinely think the Great Replacement is real, or otherwise nod along with similar scaremongering about immigrants, and I bet those people feel hard done by right now. I can imagine that Free Speech Fan 1488 has already paused the video to go, "Oh, you didn't actually debunk the Great Replacement, you just made fun of how completely fucking unhinged it sounds. She cited a newspaper article to prove that she's right. Why didn't you bother to debunk that? You're ignoring it. You're afraid of the truth." Well, hold your horses, mate. Let's look at that newspaper article in more detail. Shall we? Luckily, to her credit, Rage After Storm, in the interests of transparency, has put a link to all of the sources that she used in the description of the video, including links to where she got the Bill Nye clips from, a bunch of newspaper articles calling Bill Nye a full of shit baby man who said the bad things from places like The Federalist? Not a publication I had heard of, but that's alright. Let's just click the link to that source in the description and... oh! Weird! That link isn't in the description.
I wonder why.
Instead, I had to find it myself by googling the title. Oh boy, it's an article from The Telegraph, that bastion of accurate political reporting, entitled 9 in 10 Babies Born in Parts of Britain Have a Foreign Parent. That's the title. Do yourself a favour and keep in mind for a second the phrases 9 in 10 and Parts of Britain. Now, let's read the first paragraph. Almost 9 in 10 babies born in parts of Britain have at least one foreign-born parent, official figures have revealed for the first time. Almost 9 in 10. Well, we've already stepped back one from the headline. Almost 9 in 10 is not 9 in 10. At least parts of Britain hasn't changed. Oh well, maybe it's some big parts. That's still a lot of people with foreign-born parents, even if it was 8 in 10. How about we read the second paragraph? The Office for National Statistics disclosed that in 2012, more than 80% of babies born in three London boroughs had either one or both parents born outside the UK. Oh, some more backpedaling. Almost 9 in 10 is actually more than 80%, which they refuse to pin down with the actual percentage. I wonder why. Well, actually, I know why. It's because the number wasn't convenient enough. And these foreign-born parents' children are being born at this proportion in 3 London boroughs. Just for those of you who don't know, London has 32 boroughs. The Telegraph found a very small part of Britain with a high relative birth rate among foreign-born parents and fudged the numbers enough to get an attention-grabbing headline to make it look like we're being swarmed by immigrant babies. What they actually did was draw a very small circle around a part of the country where a lot more immigrants live than the native-born population. The figures were published amid concerns that hundreds of thousands of migrants from Romania and Bulgaria could come to Britain when restrictions are lifted in the new year. Wait. Those aren't the places Rage was talking about. Rage was talking about people from Africa, and the Great Replacement's all about diagrams of maps full of little black people overwhelming little white people, and websites pushing it tell lies about native women being encouraged to procreate with African men. This Telegraph article is scaremongering about very different groups from the current targets, who tend to be from more brown, Muslim-y countries. That's because Rage is citing an article from 2013, back when the immigration restrictions were set to be lifted, and many totally smart people feared we'd be flooded so heavily with Romanians and Bulgarians that the country would literally collapse back into the ocean from the added weight, which, as we all know, literally happened. Just kidding. This reasonable, rational thinker who thinks they've out-scienced Bill Nye tried to scaremonger about immigration from the wrong place than the one they're talking about by citing the headline of a 3-year-old article that all but admits it's completely misrepresenting the actual data a few paragraphs in. Hey, look, I think we figured out why she didn't bother linking it in the description. Also note that when she does show the text of the article, it's blurred, so you can't pause it and check to see how heavily distorted the article is being with the truth. Weird how she knew to do that. Almost as if she knows the source is full of shit, but didn't think anyone would bother to check. Now, if you're anything like me, and I certainly hope not, you're probably wondering why, of all the articles to cite about immigration and overpopulation, why she would pick such an old one, scaremongering about immigration from a different place. Like, why of all things would this article or its data form the basis for her claims? Let's assume that you're gullible and you've been tricked into believing the lie that foreigners are coming to outbreed you, and you're so sure it's right that you don't feel the need to do any research, but you know you need to look like you did to seem credible, so you need a news story to flash up that looks like it supports you. How would you find an article that suits your needs? Well, if it was me, I would Google something ridiculous like too many foreign babies and pick the one with the most attention-getting headline that also looks like it did some actual statistical analysis. You know, like maybe the fourth one down even. This attitude to science, studies, information, and facts is probably one of the many reasons why Rage and others found Nye's recent work so baffling. It appears that many people, without ever actually checking anything, have already decided what the truth is about issues of gender or immigration or global warming. Speaking of denying the science of climate change, I made a joke about Steven Crowder in the last video and a bunch of people went, "Ooh, is he gonna do Crowder next?" And I hate to disappoint my fan. So let's take a look at some of Stevie's work about Nye's recent work. That's an awful, I'll retake that. Let's have a look at some of Stevie's recent work about Nye's I did it again. I've saved myself the job of really having to go through his claims about the gender episode because I've covered all the main ones already, and as we've already covered, these people have a habit of repeating each other's points.
He's making the case that gender exists on a spectrum. By the way, very different if you go back to his old show, he did say that chromosomes determine gender. If you go back to the episodes when we were kids. So he's done a 180 on that.
So instead I'll point out that his real beef with Nye comes from how Bill's vocal about climate change and doing something about it, and Crowder is sure that the science doesn't support man-made climate change, and he has some counter-arguments that he's sure are good.
And then you have evidence, and the evidence disagrees with your worldview, so you deny the evidence, and then along with that, you deny the authorities that are providing the evidence.
You will not deny the authorities? Now we're going to be talking—
Eee! A talking a German voice authoritarian joke! Why, that's almost as good as knowing the science! Who wants to take a bet with me that at some point he's recently made a video accusing the left of calling everyone Nazis and how unproductive that is? Just kidding, I've seen more than one of his videos, so I know he does that. The left has been so busy calling everyone Nazis. Who would dare invoke needless comparison to the Nazis? What sort of imbecile would dare do something like that? Ah no, he's just talking authoritatively in a German voice. That's not necessarily invoking comparison to the Nazis for political points.
completely unrelatedly, just, you know, nothing to do with the last sentence, here's a segment from a video that he did about Nye on climate change.
Now everybody, science is political.
Science is political. Incorrect. First, let me draw your attention to the definition of science. The intellectual and practical activity...
Oh my god. I forgot that he actually cites the dictionary definition of science to try and avoid accepting the basic fact that, like, in order to stop the world from melting down, scientists might have to try and influence policy. Wait, no, this gets worse, doesn't it?
Merging politics and science, not allowing them to exist autonomously of each other, can only serve to alter science's trajectory to the path of truth. Okay? That's the main purpose here, and Bill Nye wants that specifically. Some examples? I know it seems tired and old hat, but let's go to Nazi Germany. That's kind of a prime example of political science. It also, of course, led to gassing a few individuals.
You heard me right. If scientists try to make the government listen to the effects of global warming and do something about it, it's the same as the Holocaust.
With Steven Crowder, it's honestly a laugh a minute watching him flip-flop between comparing everyone he doesn't like to the Nazis and their genocides, and complaining that way too many people are comparing things to the Nazis nowadays, especially those leftists, who are the only ones that do it.
But where are the other scientists speaking up? Kind of like with Islam. Where are the Muslims speaking up against the acts of terrorism, not only against terrorism?
Weird how in the same video, where Crowder goes from saying how dangerous political science was to the Jews, he then, for seemingly no reason, decides to start spreading the, like, legit lie that Muslims don't condemn terror attacks. You know, I expected this video to contain lies about Bill Nye and the science. I did not expect it to contain lies about Muslims. I guess when you only have two talking points, you gotta find a way to fit them in somehow, right?
You know, Steve, there are many gigantic lists out there of Muslims and Muslim groups that have come out against so-called Islamic terror. But I can't think of a single Muslim who's condemned global warming. Coincidence?
Where are the Muslims speaking up against the acts of terrorism?
It's very weird how he has to keep quibbling about nonsense instead of easily debunking the data he says can be easily debunked.
And when he really does get around to trying to actually debunk climate science, when he's not saying people wanting to do something about it are Nazis, he's doing such a poor job of debunking it that you don't even need me to show you the flaws in his understanding. Even racists can accept climate change is a problem that begs a solution.
Problem when it comes to climate change.
Yes, I agree that climate change is an actual problem and it needs to be sorted out, and we do need to sort out the consummation of electricity and...
I'm honestly really quite stunned that in the middle of a video complaining about the bisexual agenda, spreading racist lies, scaremongering about immigration, and whose description has to defend the fact that she says Bill Nye has a Jewish nose, Lady Stormfront still manages to have a better stance on climate change than Steven Crowder. That's the lowest bar I've ever seen. And Crowdy Wowdy has just tripped over it and fallen into a well. And it's not just rage that puts Crowder to shame. If you want to see his claims get debunked in more detail, there are many good videos out there by the seminal and personally inspirational Potholer 54 and... Armored Skeptic? Oh, that's right. We just came full circle.
And the Antarctic ice sheet showed a net gain of 112 billion tons of ice per year.
But you didn't mention that there's also a net loss for the entire planet. Greenland also has a major ice sheet. The total net ice loss for Greenland is an average of 269 billion tons of ice every year. So the planet suffers a net loss of 147 billion tons of ice every year.
You see, Skeptic was wrong about most of the issues he brought up about Nye's show because he doesn't really have a grasp of the related science, but he's right enough about climate science to know Crowder's full of shit.
The truly interesting thing about Skeptic and those like him is that if you pay attention, you can quite easily discern the places where they've actually decided to employ reason and skepticism and proper fact-checking, and the places where a sort of party line has formed of the same arguments repeating themselves over and over, but no one's really thought about the issue in that much detail. For these people, ignoring the latter and the parts where they just kind of complain about the SJWs, the former can actually be quite informative and interesting. Not always, but quite often. This schism is interesting, and the solution isn't all that hard. It actually just means employing reason and skepticism, but even more about even more things. it would be nice if he acknowledged the existence of my video criticizing him, or even tried to respond at all to the points in it. But I know how long this kind of thing can take. You've got to pick what you cover with your time very carefully or nothing gets done, and I certainly can't criticize anyone for doing what they think is right with the time they have. For example, I've spent nearly 2 months of my life reading data and biology books and studies about trans people and reading about the lived experiences of being trans in order to come to a better understanding before broaching this topic and responding to criticism, before realizing that most of the criticism didn't do any research and there was really no reason for me to do most of that reading, and I've had basically no chances to show all the work I did in this video, and I'm thoroughly disappointed in myself. I accidentally took the time to educate myself, to no benefit other than my own personal expansion of knowledge, like some kind of loser who thinks that's important. And to think I did all that, just to respond to videos covering an episode of a show that I didn't think was very good at covering the issues anyway. I want to close by focusing on a section of that episode that a lot of people complained about, probably because it rightfully made them feel uncomfortable, because it made me feel a bit uncomfortable too.
So I'm going to ask for a little help with that, and who better to talk about sex than two cis male white guys?
It sat with me because I really can't avoid what it's pointing out. I can talk all day about whatever the right way to discuss or present these issues might be, but at the end of that day, I will still be an outsider to those issues. I was deeply curious what the opinion of someone who's actually affected by these issues might be about the show, so I reached out to trans YouTuber Zinnia Jones for her perspective on the issues, and she sent me this. Let's watch.
Hi, I'm Zinnia Jones. I'm a trans woman, and I've been covering transgender issues on YouTube for several years. Personally, I enjoyed Bill Nye's presentation of the spectrum of gender and sexuality. As a trans person, I've often found coverage of these topics for a cisgender audience to be oversimplified or awkward, but this episode was surprisingly painless and even charming, and it offered a nuanced explanation of human diversity that's sadly lacking in most media. I was glad to see such a high-profile presentation of concepts that I and other trans advocates have been raising awareness of for years, such as the decoupling of gender from sex and the recognition of non-binary genders. The use of gender expression in South Korea's culture was a great concrete example of how our ideas about gender can be actively shaped by societal influences. And I felt that the ice cream segment was pretty effective in connecting sexuality to something that people can viscerally understand in their lives. Being told that your favorite flavor of ice cream is wrong would make no sense. And as they depicted, the people who feel the need to try and rewrite their sexual orientation do tend to end up in some very queer situations. As someone who loved watching Bill Nye as a kid, I'll admit it was a bit strange to hear a song about handjobs and power bottoms. But on the whole, I think this episode is a good introduction for people who may not be aware of what we now know about the full range of gender and sexuality.
When I went to find an alternative perspective, I had kind of banked on it kind of semi-resembling the one I'd had. Like, it would have been really convenient for me if I could end the video with, "Hey, remember what I thought about the episode? Well, here's someone who knows way more about the issue, and they agree with me!" But no, it turns out my perspective can be flawed. I think Zinnia makes an interesting point that I completely missed. Ultimately, Bill Nye's doing what Bill Nye has always done: provide a rudimentary, baseline explanation of a topic to an audience whose science education may well have ended in high school. Like when we discussed the act of writing an episode of this show earlier, pointing this out puts a lot of this episode in perspective. Nye's show is for such a broad audience of folks who may not know anything about the topic. In a way, the only people who this episode isn't for are people who already think a lot about the topic, people who live the topic because it's a part of their daily lives, and of course, people who think that by simply thinking about this issue too much, you've taken the wrong side in a culture war, something, something liberal agenda, blah, blah, too pro-gay. Now, at this point, I am contractually obliged to mention that exposure to this video directly may make you up to 15% more gay. So, it's highly recommended that you wear your ideological protection goggles provided underneath your hang on a second. Why is this written at the end of the script?
Hey there, thanks for watching. I'd like to thank Horikawa Otane for letting me butcher her name like that, and also for help with the research that went into making this video. If there's any mistakes, it's because I forgot to run them past her. I'd also like to thank Zinnia Jones for recording her contribution, that was very nice of her, and also Contrapoints for recording that one line, which she did on incredibly short notice, like the day before this video was going to come out. Thank you very much for that, Contra. Most of the music used in this video, including the song you're hearing right now, was created by Christa from her album Fantasy Zone, a tribute to the music of various Sega games. It's on Bandcamp, check it out, link in the description. And, finally, thanks to all my lovely patrons for enabling me. In addition to the names going past the screen right now, I'd especially like to thank 3/5 of a Brain, a bunch of question marks, I hope that's not an error on the list I made, A Bowl of Creamy Tomato Soup, Aislinn, Aiden Bradley, Al Swigert, Alex Lemkovich, Alexander R. Corbett, Alexander Wendler, Alicia Parker Martell, Amy Lech, Andrew Gilly, Andrew Scheimer, Avi Finkel, Anna S. B-movie, but every time they say B, I donate $10 to hbomberguy, Benjamin Davidson, Besotten Jenny, Big Boy, Big Fan, Brennan Arts, Burrett Plouf, Cal Ashton, Caleb McMurphy, Christopher McDonald, Christopher Wade, Kieran, Claw Sue, Kabiza, Commissar Taco, Corwin Light Williams, Daniel Han, Daniel Stewart, Daniel Sullivan, Daniel Vincent Chilton, Dash of Week, Dave Kemp, David Craggs, David Rose, David the Benevolent Malevolence, Davis Remy, Donald Drumpf should have a cactus forcibly inserted into his rectum, Eden Yankovic Sumar, Aiden Goldstrom, Elijah Scanlon, Elliot Soden, Eric Hunter, Eugene Butler, Evan Ritchie, Fully Automated Luxury Post-Scarcity Communism, Feely's Den, Femininja, Findlay Bowick Copley, George Soros, Gar Internet, Garrett Lathy, Garrett Mitchell, Gary Marshall, Geeky Apar, Get Dunked On, Gnostic Dude, Grafen Blackpaw, Gracie Lipscomb, hbomberguy but with yaoi hands, Handsome Unlimited, Heba Assad, Heretic Void, Hero of Time 88, Hi, I'm hbomberguy, and I love breaded mac and cheese. Oh, you think you're so clever. Hero Reward. I don't know, like a butt or something. I'm Neapolitan. I'm Daddy's little bitch. Seriously though, I'm trapped inside of a... Ian Weeklock Scott. It turns out I was wrong about everything. Jack Harvey. Jacqueline Merritt. Jakucha Boris. James. James Adair. James Id. Jan Anders Bremer. Johan actually had to send me a recording of him pronouncing his name for me to get it right. I've been pronouncing his name wrong for like a year. I'm so sorry, Johan. Jason Durso, Jason Walter, Jeffrey Theobald, Jenny Angel, Jeremy, Jerry Terry, Joe Haynes, Joe Cantwell, Jordan Barrett, Jordan Tullis, Justin Conquerbeard, Justin Partridge, Justin Schwendiman, K Played Dota. Congratulations on getting over your addiction. Calfsile. Catherine Wilde, Catherine, Kelly Mariella K, Kevin Thurber, Kiki329, Kit Foley, Klil H. Niori, Kurt C. Yost, Lauren, Lewis Woodrow, Lucas Cocon, Luke Swanson, Max Barbecue King, Mackenzie Cockerill, Marco Shard, Mark Harmon, Matthew Harris, MacArthur, Michael H. Prey, Michael Jackson's Children's Hospital, biggest children's hospital in the world, Mike Stanley, Minty Freakin' Fresh, except now she's old enough to legally drink alcohol. Momi. Mon Silfoplatz Toonstrom. Naoto Shiragane. Nathan Hoare. Nathan and Bronwyn. Never tickle a Wookiee's sphincter unless you're wearing rubber gloves. Niflet, with three T's. Niltiak, Stealer of Souls. Owen Piper. Patrick, the Breezy P. Finnegan. Paul Lasswell. Philip Coffey. Procor. Rebecca Harold. Rebecca Washam. Recovering Zombie. Ree Mansell, Renee Larshaug, Richard Pearson, Ricard Hevosmar, Riley Van Dyke, Robert Phillips, Rossetti, Rosie Forbes, Rue, Ryan Van Shark, Ryan William Cox, Sam Bayliss, Samael, Sammy J, Samuel Butler, Scott Gertin, Sean Kemp, Shadowbag, Sean Higgins, Sheena Artrip, Siegfried, Slayer of the Immortal Dragon, Silas Pumpkins, Syntharama, Sol, Spunker McGraw, Starman Nabby, Stephen Cohn, Talash, Tapio Unto Oscari Taronan, Thadwazalewski, the Almighty Quackosaurus, the Frankfurt Shoal, the Joke Daddy, the Spectre of Commulism, Thomas Kistner, Threnody, Tom Martell, Torrin Schofield, Totally Radical Politics, Tyler Howard, Ure, Vagabond to Be, Vandella Ridbeck, Wargobble Smurf, Whackman, Wiebke, Wouter de Hoogd, XXX underscore Swagmaster 420 underscore XXX, Zachary Clark, Zoe Britton, Zoe Gawin, Chiboy Kamikensei, Devon's Hands Melt, don't forget to subscribe to the official Doctor Who YouTube channel, Hort Dog, Lissy Roberts, Parker Anderson, Rikami, Robbie Fox, several rats participating in an elaborate and daring casino heist, Supercala Nihilistic Expialidocious, the godforsaken strongest rat alive, why are there always rats at the end of the credits, Willow H, Zodak, and Ace Jenny.
It's good to be back. Oh, fuck! That was a complete accident. Shit! Are you okay, Mr. Skeleton?
That was completely unscripted. I did not do that on purpose. It just fell down. Jesus.